गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट पार्ट इन प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट, दैट इज एनालिसिस ऑफ सिमेट्रिकल एंड अनसिमेट्रिकल सेक्शंस. सो ऑलरेडी लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर्स. ओके, व्हाई वी हैव टू यूज हाई स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट, व्हाई वी हैव टू यूज हाई स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ स्टील ग्रेड. ओके, दोज थिंग्स एंड ऑन विच प्रिंसिपल्स इट वर्क्स, दैट डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेस, बेंडिंग स्ट्रेस एंड कंबाइंड स्ट्रेस. ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द वन न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑफ वन रेक्टेंगल सेक्शन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द वेरियस स्ट्रेसेस इन द बीम. ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वी हैव टू मेट यू हैव टू फॉलो द सम अजम्पशंस. Like you people already know that in RCC also we have followed some assumptions, and based upon assumptions we have designed the we have derived the various formulas which is required for RCC design. Okay, same here we have to make some assumptions. First assumption is the traverse plane section of the member will remain a plane after bending also. Already this assumptions we have made in RCC also, that section transverse, okay, plane section of the member will remain plane after the bending also. Okay, within, so that means, just I will explain you. One minute, just. So here, what is mean that plane section is normal to the transverse section is plane after bending also. So if you consider one beam, we have drawn the longitudinal section. The section, if you are going to see any beam, any member, when you are going to cut along the length, that is called a longitudinal section. Okay, if this is longitudinal length of this is beam. Okay, and if you are going to cut the beam across its length, okay, that section is called a transverse section. Means if you are going to cut beam like this, yeah, if you are going to cut beam through this, so you can cut section like this. So assumption is like this, when after bending also, this transverse section, this transverse section, okay, remain plane after bending. This is assumption. So that assumption also we have considered in RCC also. So this is first assumption. So this is first assumption, or transverse plane section of member will remain plane after bending also. And second, within the limits of deformation taking place, Hooke's law is applicable for concrete and steel component. Means within the limit of deformation, if you have assigned the deformation limits, okay, up to that the Hooke's law is applicable to the concrete and steel component also. What is Hooke's law? Hooke's law is nothing but the stress is directly proportional to the strength. That is Hooke's law, and up to the certain deformation limit Hooke's law is takes place. Okay, next, the stress in the reinforcement does not changes along the length of reinforcement. So here the stress of reinforcement does not changes along the length of reinforcement. Means here we are not going to assume here, we are not going to consider here stress variation in the reinforcement. Okay, whatever the stress variation takes place here, stress changes take place for the concrete component only. So we are going to consider the various stress changes in concrete component only. We are not going to consider any stresses. The stress reinforcement does not changes along the length of reinforcement. Okay, so we are not going to calculate the stress changes in a reinforcement. Okay, that is in tendon. So variation of stress in the reinforcement due to change in the external loading is also ignored. Means whatever external load is applied, and due to that we are going to ignore, which thing we are going to ignore? Variation of stress in a reinforcement due to external loading, that we are going to ignore. So these are the assumptions we are going to consider while we are going to design the pre-stressed concrete member. So next, Before going to start the design analysis of precious concrete member, here are three basic concepts, and based upon these three basic concepts, we are going to design three basic concepts here. First concept is stress concept, second is the strength concept, and third is the load balancing concept. We are going to calculate the stresses in beam by considering these three concepts. In stress concept, we have to make sure that whatever the beam section we are going to consider, that section, that concrete is in full usually elastic state. Okay, that we have to achieve in the stress concept. In strengthening concept, we are going to see that, how is concrete and steel is going to give the increase the strength in the strength concept. Okay, and load balancing concept, we are going to balance the external load, whatever the external load that we are going to balance through the tendon. Okay, these are the three concepts. See here, three different concepts may be applied to the explain and analyze the basic behavior of the pre-stressed concrete. So these three concepts are as follow: stress concept, to transform concrete into an elastic material; second, pre-stressing for combination of high strength and concrete, or strength of steel and concrete; and load balancing concept, pre-stressing to achieve the load balancing. Okay, in detail we are going to see these three concepts. So first we are going to start analysis of beam by using the stress concept. Okay, analysis by using stress concept. So here, before this is very important thing, because we are going to just start now the analysis part of a pre-stressed concrete beam, and this is the important thing. This is the important page to understand. If you are going to understand this thing, it is very easy for you people to do the remaining calculation for various problems. Okay, so see here, just I have taken one simply supported beam. So supports are simple, and the beam having the length here, L length, and beam is applied, the beam is provided with the central tendon, okay, along the centroid axis, and with subjected with the UDF, okay, and we have applied the forces here through the tendon on the beam. Those forces we are considered pre-stressing force, we have considered capital P. Okay, if I am going to interested to calculate the stresses at mid section of the beam, means if I am going to cut here the beam, so you can see the cross section of beam like this. And for cross section of beam, here we have considered the width of beam is B and depth of beam is a small d. Okay, so this is cross section. Now due to this pre-stressing force and this external load, okay, that superimposed load, what happened, which the beam is subjected with the various moments and stresses. Okay, so first we are going to calculate the stresses. All you people know, these two forces are compression forces. Okay, the pre-stressing forces will going to act on this cross section of the beam. So you people know stress is equal to what? Stress is equal to the basic formula. So stress is equal to sigma is equal to P by A. So if you want to calculate any stress, you are going to use this formula. Already in SM1 we have seen this formula, stress is equal to force upon area. So here, if you want to get the stress here, so stress, this stress here, so here I am going to use this formula. So P by A, so P here pre-stressing force, and area B D. So here I use the formula here, P by A, to calculate the stress. And stress is in compression. See here, with these two pre-stressing forces, okay, pushing beam inside. Okay, so that's why this section is subjected with the compression, and for compression we are always use the sign plus, and tension we are used the sign minus. Okay, so due to this pre-stressing force, the stress due to the pre-stressing point, this stress is called as a direct stress. Okay, so next here, after getting direct stress, P by A is the direct stress, just you have to this pre-stressing force divided by area, plus this beam is not only subjected with this pre-stressing force, stress due to pre-stressing force, the beam having the UDL, that is self weight of beam, and the external load. Okay, so due to that, beam is going to bend. How beam is going to bend? Simply supported beam, the beam is going to bend like this, and beam is going to bend like this at cross section. Beam is subjected with top compression and bottom tension. And if you are going to see the neutral axis, you are going to see if you are going to consider the neutral axis, the neutral axis is going to divide the two zones, so as compression zone and tension zone. So for stresses due to bending, we have to calculate the bending stresses. So bending stresses also formula, okay, m by z, you people know. So m by z is just a formula used for to calculate the bending stresses. Here m is the moment and z is the section modulus. So section modulus we can write like this also. M is equal to z is equal to I by y. So you can write formula also like this, m by y into I. Like this also you can use the formula. But here you have used formula m by z. Okay, and these stresses are called as the bending stresses, as stresses due to the bending moment. Those are the bending stresses. So m by z, m by z. So at top here a compression. So this plus sign we have used, and after neutral axis sign is going to change because this here is the tension. So here we have considered the minus sign. So simple thing here, the simply supported beam is subjected with the pre-stressing force P and subjected with the EODL, that is external load. Or self weight, include self weight of beam or not including the self weight of beam. Okay, we have to consider that both thing. Okay, UDL here and self weight of beam. So by considering that, we have to calculate the moment. Okay, and if you know the moment, you can calculate the bending stresses. These are the bending stresses. Bending stresses. And addition of these two, if you are going to consider the summation of the all stresses due to this pre-stressing force and this UDL on the beam, or load on external, superimposed load on the beam. So addition is like this, P by A is here plus, M by Z is a plus, so here formula. So maximum stress at top fiber of the beam means if you are going to consider the top fiber, so sigma T if you are going to consider, the stresses at sigma T, the stresses at top compression fiber will be P by A plus M by Z. And stresses at bottom fiber of the beam, here this sigma B is equal to P by A minus M by Z. So simple thing, this we have to use here, and we are going to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, see here, please understand one thing. In RCC we have used only this diagram because in RCC there is a no pre-stressing force. So in RCC we ignore this thing. So in RCC we have used this thing, and in RCC our diagram is like this, and here is a tension. So when there is a tension, we have used reinforcement here, but we are avoiding the reinforcement here. We are neglecting the neglecting the tension by providing the compression force. And how we are introducing this compression force? This compression force we are going to introduce the by providing the tendon. And this is the definition of pre-stressing. What is the definition? Pre-stressing beam, we have seen the member, we have seen the definition. Developing the member in which we are going to develop the internal stresses in a planned manner. Okay, to counteract, which thing you have to counteract? To counteract this superimposed load. Okay, we have provided the force like this, this P by A stress, to get this positive, to counteract this negative. So section, whole section become in a compression. So here see, the section, the full section is a compression, so here is no tension. So if section is in compression, the full section is going to utilize, because see here, the section with neutral axis now concrete is also useful because here compression stresses are developed. Okay, and no tensile stresses, so no need to provide the reinforcement here. So this is the basic concept, and this concept we are using in a stress concept also. Okay, the principle, that principle you are using in stress concept also. Okay, now based upon this, now we are going to solve one problem. Here we are going to put the numerical values, and we are going to calculate the top stresses and bottom stresses in the beam. How typically you are going to face problem in an exam, that also I am going to take now. So see here, I have taken one problem. That problem is like this. A pre-stressed concrete beam 400 mm by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter and is subjected to a uniformly distributed load of 18 kN meter including the self weight of beam. Here you have to include the self weight in this 18. The pre-stressing tendon which are located along the longitudinal centroid axis provide an effective pre-stressing force of 1000 kN. Okay, so remember this thing, where they have given the pre-stressing tendon which are located along the longitudinal centroid axis. The position of tendon is very important. The when the position of tendon is going to change, the stresses are also going to change at top compression fiber and bottom compression of fiber of the beam. And in assumption, we have clearly we have assumed that we are going to calculate the stresses at only concrete section. Okay, at top fiber and bottom fiber only. And here, after knowing this all given data, we are going to see determine the extreme fiber stresses in concrete at mid-span section. At mid-span section, here you can see here at mid. Okay, here we have to take this mid-span section, we have to cut section, and here we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So how to calculate stresses? First thing I am going to calculate. So here I know the formula now. To get the stresses, I have maximum sigma t top stresses and bottom stresses. I have to use only this formula P by A plus minus M by Z. Okay, so this formula I have to use. Okay, and in this formula, which terms are required? Then those terms I am going to calculate here initially. So first thing, cross sectional area. So here A is a cross sectional area, so cross sectional area 400 by 600, so this value become 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 mm square. Same way, next thing I required section modulus Z. So section modulus Z is equal to, I consider a BD square by 6. How I consider this BD square by 6, I will explain you. So formula for section modulus, already I have told you, Z is equal to I by Y, moment of inertia divided by the distance where from bottom, where that section modulus, that moment of inertia is going to act. So Z is equal to, sorry, the central axis. So moment of inertia for rectangle section BD cube by 12 divided by the distance of Y. So distance of Y D by 2. So if I am going to calculate the value of Z, so this DD get cancelled. So this becomes now d square, and 12 divided by 2, so this is will be 6. So section modulus here will get bd square by 6. So that bd square by 6 we have used here, and by using that we are calculating the section modulus. Okay, so bd square by 6, section dimensions 400 into 600 square divided by 6, 2.4 into 10 raised to 7 mm cube. Here section modulus. Next, maximum bending moment. The beam is simply supported having the length 6 meter. You people know the bending moment formula for simply supported beam at midsection, at max center. Okay, that is WL square by 8. So here put the value given, 18 into 6 square divided by 8. Will this moment will be the 18 kN meter. Okay. Next here. Now we have to calculate the direct stresses. So direct stresses already we have seen, direct stresses P by A. So just I am putting the value of P we have calculated here. The value of P they have given, the pre-stressing force here. So that PV is 1000 kN. So 1000 kN, A which you have calculated just now 2.4. So 2.4 into 10 raised to 5. So this value becomes plus 4.16 Newton per mm square. So here is the direct stress value. Okay, which is positive. So extreme stress due to bending moment. So bending moment the value will be the plus minus M by Z. Moment we have calculated just now, that moment is 18 kN meter. So 18 into 10 raised to 6, we have to consider this value Newton per mm. So we have multiplied with the 10 raised to 6. Section modulus we have calculated here Z, 2.4 into 10 raised to 7 is equal to, and this value then become plus minus 3.3. So we have calculated now the both stresses, direct stresses and the external stresses, that bending stresses. Okay, now we have to add these two stresses, okay, final stresses, because already we have seen this. After getting these direct stresses P by A and M by Z, we have to add these two. At top there is addition, and bottom there is a subtraction due to tension. So here final stresses at extreme fiber will be as follows. So final stresses in the extreme top fiber, so sigma t here plus P by A plus M by Z. If I am putting the stress, I have got here plus 7.54, and the final stresses in the extreme fiber, okay, at bottom, so plus P by A minus M by Z plus 4.16 minus 3.38, so it become plus 0.78, okay, or 78 Newton per mm square. So I have got that these two values. Okay, how can then the final stress diagram I can see? So like, see here, section is this, direct stresses P by I have calculated 4.16 plus, I have calculated the bending stresses M by Z plus 3.38, here minus 3.38. If I am going to add these two, the value 7.54 and 0.78. What happened now in this section of the beam at mid section, the stress at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So stress at top fiber is 7.54 and bottom 0.74, and these stresses are compressive stresses. Okay, so whole section is in compression. So whatever we have assumed initially, that section will become in a compression by providing the pre-stressing force. So here you can see, by providing the pre-stressing force, by introducing the direct stresses in the beam, we can achieve thing, and here tensile stresses are ignored. Okay, so this is okay now, and here now these compression stresses concrete can take, and role of the tendon is only to transfer the pre-stressing force, and here now beam is set. Okay, and we have calculated the various stresses as per our requirement. Okay, so this is end of our today's session. Next session, again I am going to take the problem where we have here we have considered tendon at exactly central axis. Now what happened when we are going to provide tendon with and some eccentricity from center, how we are going to change the things are going to change, that we are going to see. Okay, so we are going to stop here. Thank you all of you.